Hi, I'm Ken Pope from Pope Instrument Repair, and this is the first in our series of how you can try to fix your own horn. We're going to start with something simple, and it's going to be how to take your valves out and put them back in. So, you need three things to start. You need the right tools. Down here we have the right tools. You need a hammer. You need this, which is called a valve drift or a valve punch. It can be made out of brass or wood or anything that's small enough to fit inside the stop arm of your screw of your horn. You need anything that will seat the valve back down. You can use something like this, made out of wood or the top to your valve oil. You need the valve string, which is squidding line or fly line backing, a razor blade to cut it, and a screwdriver. That's the first thing you need, the correct tools. Second thing you need is the name of a trusty repairman for when you screw up, which might happen. You'd hate to have your valves out on the night of a concert. Third thing you need is a clean workspace.
Dad. Yeah.
What?
Alright, how'd you do that?
What?
That.
I always keep my shop clean.
Yeah, alright, well, why don't you clean the rest of it then?
Okay. How to take your valves out, yeah. Smart Aleck. First step. Take the valve caps off. No laughing. I know a lot of people have done that, who've tried to take their valves out and forgotten to take the valve caps off. Not that I've ever done that.
Yeah, okay.
Step two. Take the strings off. We'll just do one valve here. We'll do the first valve. Just loosen the screws. Pull the string right out. Step three, remove the stop arm screws. This is the large screw on top of the stop arm. Next, you take your valve drift or valve punch and you insert it so it is touching only the valve, and do this over a apron or a soft surface. Set the punch on the valve and give it a good hit. Now I'm holding the bearing, the stop arm, I'm sorry. That's the stop arm. We turn the horn over. And there you have it. Your rotor and your top bearing. Nice green one at that. This isn't my horn. I keep my horn clean. What are you laughing at?
Yeah, you can't even find your horn.
So, now to put the valve back in. Pretty easy. Drop the rotor in place. Put the stop or the bearing plate in place, lining up the hash marks. And you will simply seat this by tapping it down. Now I use this, but if you don't have something like that, you can use the top of your valve oil and just give it a few good hits and look to see that it's flush with the top of the rotor. Put the valve cap back on. Put the stop arm back on with the screw. Now this horn, somebody has futzed with and replaced all the screws with completely wrong screws. And lastly, we tie the valve. You need about a 9-inch piece of string. One end, tie a knot, just like that. And now to tie this, the valve. Slip it in the back side. Go around the small screw. We can adjust the height of the valve after we have you tighten that adjustment screw. You now go under the other string and through the hole. And lastly, you make a loop to go around this screw. What I do is I roll the string in my hand so it forms this loop like that. And tighten this screw. I put a little tension pushing down as I tighten so that the string isn't overly tight. Now the screw is tight. Now, notice how it's much lower than the other ones. If we want to raise it, loosen this screw and just pull the arm back a little bit so that it's in the same position relative to the other arms. And now it's closer. I think the second one needs to be brought down a little. I didn't tie those ones. So let's bring it down a little. So I loosen that and I push the lever a little forwards. And now the valves are in line. Put on the rest of your caps and you're all done. So that's how you take a valve out and put it back in.
Alright, well, now you should take the rest of your day off to, like, clean the shop.
Okay, I'll start over. Hey, there's my horn! Stay tuned for our next installment, which will be how to take dents out with a broom handle.